Hi, I'm Cecil Mills. I'm here at the world's largest pollution-free automotive engine research laboratory in Converse, Louisiana. The reason I'm making this video is if you've been watching my YouTube channel, you know that I've been after Honda to partner up with us to, do a demonstration program of pollution-free engines and the practicality of them and the simplicity of them. And the basic principle is the cleanest fuel makes the cleanest engine. Well, it turns out the cleanest fuel is hydrogen peroxide, and you can make it from water. It's H2O2. 90% concentration of hydrogen peroxide has about 3 times the energy content of gasoline. So just imagine if you're a hot rodder and you put a 3 times more powerful fuel in your engine, it's going to be 3 times more powerful. It's just, a no-brainer. Well, Honda has been working with hydrogen fuel cells. Well, hydrogen is a gas, naturally, at ambient temperatures and pressures. And even though it has a little bit more energy content per gram or per pound or whatever than hydrogen peroxide, it's a lot harder to keep in the car. The big advantage of hydrogen peroxide is energy density. It's a liquid. It's a heavy liquid. It weighs 11.7 pounds per gallon. So even though it's twice as powerful pound per pound as gasoline, it's 3 times more powerful per gallon. So yesterday I called my friend Steve Ellis at Honda, American Honda Motors in Torrance, California there. And Steve is, I believe his exact title is the director of alternative fuels, or the alternative fuel manager. I guess I can say me and Steve are friends. I've been talking to him for nearly 3 years now, and he seems to get it. But I can tell there's opposition to using hydrogen peroxide within Honda. And yesterday when I talked to him, he goes, "I can't get it by their guy, I'm sure it's Jeff Jeter," and he said the SAE committee. Well, we're talking about the cleanest fuel there is here. This is just a no-brainer. This is a patent from Japan of somebody named, it doesn't matter. This is a patent of how to make hydrogen peroxide from seawater. Well, they got plenty of that in Japan. You can see here, seawater containing hydrogen peroxide. Well, you can make hydrogen peroxide a whole bunch of different ways. You can make it from oil, but it's called an organic process. But that's not a renewable fuel. The thing about making hydrogen peroxide from water is that's a renewable fuel. This brochure is from the government supplier. The government uses hydrogen peroxide every day, apparently. And this is a brochure from FMC. They're the government supplier. And what this says here, let me see if I can get this so you can see it exactly. It says, this is an obvious source of power or heat. Well, this side says it's 3 times more powerful than gasoline. So the reason I'm after Honda is because their engines are miraculous. I watch YouTube and it'll say engines that can rev to 10,000 RPM, half of them are Hondas. So, Honda is trying. I see the IndyCar engines run 11, 12,000 RPMs. These guys are good with engines. I think they can make this work. And the thing is, you have a little different materials and, a different engine design. The engines we have today are actually clunkers. The four-stroke engine, one of the four strokes is a power stroke. The engine cannot be more than 25% efficient. Mechanically, it's just a no-brainer here. So, I talked to Steve and Ellis there, and he seems to get it, but there's people that are opposed to it. And I have to tell you, if you say the SAE committee, these are a bunch of oil guys. They don't want something that works. You could tell this hydrogen fuel cell thing is not going anywhere. I already seen it's 9 times more expensive than gasoline cars. You know, just because the car is so complex. You have a high pressure hydrogen storage. You have the fuel cell itself. Now you got to have electric motor, a bunch of heavy wiring. And then plus all the junk you get, the cup holders and stuff you get on cars today. They're priced out of people's range. I'm talking about our whole thing has always been, this could be cheaper than gasoline at $2 a gallon, maybe less. So, Steve, I hope you're watching this, and I hope you'll get after Jeff Jeter and those guys, and do they want something that works? I can tell you that just coming out with the first pollution-free engine will be a milestone that no other car company will ever be able to claim for Honda. You understand what I'm talking about? This is there's no going back. Once you say there's pollution-free engines, there's no going back. But we don't even have words to talk about what kind of engine we're talking about here. I'm saying pollution-free. But what if the engine puts oxygen back into the air? This is the only thing that people have to breathe. It's worth breathing. I don't know what to say about that. We could restore the atmosphere. In some of my other videos, I tell you what we've done to the air. And it'll be a long time before we get right again. But, Steve, you need to step up. And if you can't get by Jeff Jeter, go to some of those Japanese executives and show them this video and say, you know, this guy might have something here. And he doesn't want very much. Nothing like you paid for the fuel cell. Chrysler was my sponsor, I told Steve yesterday. They were my sponsor, not a very big sponsor. You know, I'm not getting $1 million from them or nothing. But they paid $447 million, $500 million for the rights to the fuel cell, and haven't sold the first fuel cell car that I know of anyway. So, you know, I'm talking about cars you can sell and the cars that people want and cars like we have never seen yet. So, you know, all I really want to do is have a little demonstration program with Honda, and I want to assign the rights to my patents and stuff to Honda, because I believe I'll have a stronger position in the market, and Honda can participate in that, and whatever patents they develop, they'll have for them. And that's really a big part of the car business these days. Let's not be silly about it. There's no doubt. You tell Jeff Jeter, is there a cleaner fuel than hydrogen peroxide? He can't say that. Is there a safer fuel than hydrogen peroxide? He can't say that. I don't care how long he's been a chemist. It's just not happening. This is the cleanest fuel. This is the safest fuel. And you can make it from seawater. So, maybe Jeff doesn't like it. Maybe the SAE committee doesn't like it. They think it's fine about hydrogen cars because that's not going to work. They're afraid of something that will work. It'll take the power from the oil companies and give it back to... It's not just the power, it's the air we breathe here, Steve. So send this video around Honda and let them see what they think here. I'm going to send it around Honda. So... thanks for watching.